After protests and controversy, six French Quarter strip clubs have reached an agreement with the Office of Alcohol and Tobacco Control.
And five of those clubs were scheduled to have a hearing tomorrow to figure out if the suspensions of the club's liquor licenses were justified. And Jade Cunningham joins us now with more on what this means. Jade?
Natalie and Ton, one of those clubs has actually shut down operations entirely. Five others will have to pay a fine, and they'll have their liquor license temporarily suspended. And the announcement of this agreement comes after a heated day on Bourbon Street. A city press conference regarding the Bourbon Street reconstruction project came to a halt when a large group of protesters let their voices be heard.
There's still no police to protect me when I walk to my car after work, but we repaved Bourbon Street. Great job.
The group of exotic dancers and other club employees spoke out about recent raids that took place in eight strip clubs on and around Bourbon. The NOPD, state police, and the ATC suspended their liquor licenses after finding instances of prostitution, drug use, and other lewd acts. On Monday, Covenant House Director Jim Kelly told Eyewitness News he applauds the enforcement.
This is not about the dancers. It's about owners and managers. The employees of those clubs should be able to work in a prostitution-free, drug-free workplace, just like any other restaurant or club in the French Quarter.
Others disagree.
Are bad things happening in the clubs? Absolutely not.
Some employees claim the findings are nonsense, saying the suspensions have hurt them rather than helped.
It's a place that represented stability and financial security for me. It's the only reason I was able to leave my abusive relationship, and now they've closed the only place that gives me what I need to survive.
To have not only my passion, but my income threatened by an outside force that is completely illegitimate. It's not right. And if we don't stand up for it, then no one else is going to.
Which was the message demonstrators wanted the city to hear Wednesday, standing together for what they believe in.
These streets have been open for a few weeks, so to call this a ribbon cutting in the middle of shutting down all these clubs and saying welcome to the new Bourbon Street, we know exactly what the city is trying to imply, and that is not the case. These clubs aren't going away. These clubs have been a part of what Bourbon Street is.
At this time, three of those clubs have not reached an agreement with the ATC. Their hearings are scheduled for February 6th. Reporting live, Jay Cunningham, Eyewitness News.